fighting with, you know, against this giant needed a lot of faith.
Yeah.
And it needed a lot of backing from heaven. Mm-hmm. Because all the soldiers, the Israelite soldiers, were like, whoa. Whoa. And David was like, aye, who's this uncircumcised Philistine who's, you know, mocking my God? Yes. And so he was able to fight against Goliath, and Goliath died. Yes. Now, we could all see David as this warrior and all that. And that is because he had faith in God, mm-hmm. and God fought for him. Mm-hmm. Now, we're going to do a little bit of a demonstration. I have my David and Goliath in studio today. Yeah. And they are not strangers to you. You already know them. You have seen them on the screen. And they will be demonstrating to us how it is to fight on your own without God first, or without the backing of heaven first. Mm-hmm. And then after that, we will see what it is like being fought for by the Lord himself.
Oh, yes.
So I'll get my actresses in studio on air, Sahi Wakuje, mm-hmm. so that we see what it means first to be fought or to fight on your own, mm-hmm. and to be fought for.
Yes.
Are you ready?
Oh yes.
Tuwaone.
Kabisa.
Tuwaone basi. Yes. Here comes the giant, David and Goliath. Welcome. How are you? We have Mumbi Mavuti of Medicamp and Sharon, our director on Arise. She is right here and they are about to demonstrate to us. So Alice, yes. You being David, assume that Sharon, the Goliath, ameku agitate and you want to fight.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Kindly, let's see how that will work out. You need to fight. Uh-huh.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Whoa. Uh-huh. All right. At this rate, Kindelea, Mumbi will need leave. Two months. All right. Thank you so much. But now, I would like to include our guest.
Yes.
Danielle. Mm-hmm. She'll be standing behind Alice.
Mm-hmm.
All right. And we are going to see how it works out, mm-hmm. for Alice when she is being fought for,
yes.
by the Lord himself, having worn the full armor, mm-hmm. of Christ. All right, let's go.
So, you know, God will just allow some things,
uh-huh.
sometimes.
God, yeah.
Keep going
through.
Yes. All
right.
Yeah.
Wow. Beautiful. And finally, Alice is safe. Thanks to the Lord. Thanks to our actresses. Thank you so much. Beautiful. I always tell you, GTN TV is the home of gifts and talents. Did you know you had the acting ability in you?
You know, we keep exploring every day.
We do.
We find out new things.
Uh-huh. And today was your first day?
Yeah.
Okay.
Kidogo. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I could tell.
Yes.
So welcome to the show.
Thank you very much.
Yes, again, dear viewers, we have Danielle Kitho in studio. That will be your camera. I would like you to say hi to the viewers. Tell us who you are. Introduce, mm-hmm. yourself. Vizuri. Yes.
So my name is Danielle Kamere Kitho. Mm-hmm. I am a wife to one amazing man.
Wow.
His name is Noah Kitho.
Beautiful.
I am a mother of two boys. I am... Together with my husband, we are pastors,
uh-huh.
in Living Faith Ministries.
Beautiful.
Under Bishop Jack Kamere, uh-huh. and Reverend Emily Kamere.
Uh-huh.
And I'm a teacher by profession.
Okay.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
I teach English and music.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
What else? I love the Lord.
Beautiful.
So much.
Amen.
Ile tu mingivi. Mingivi.
Kabisa.
Yes.
Yeah. Wow.
There's so much, mm-hmm. I can say about myself, but... Yeah. That is me in, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A nutshell.
Yes.
Why? Mm-hmm. You're in a nutshell, dear viewer. What's your nutshell like? Wow. So again, welcome to GTN TV. It's such an honor to have you.
Mm-hmm.
And it's such a beautiful thing that you said you teach music.
Yes.
Meaning you're so good at it.
Oh, yeah. Oh, well.
Well.
Yes.
Well. kujiamini ni muhimu. Yes, yes. And I can attest to it that she is indeed really talented. And because of that, huku lazima utatuimbia. And I think that should be the first thing before we even get to know your story.
Yes.
So kindly, take it away.
All right.
All right.
We give you glory, Lord, as we honor you. We give you glory, Lord, as we honor you. You are wonderful. You are worthy, oh Lord. You are wonderful. You are worthy, oh Lord. You are wonderful. You are worthy, oh Lord. You are wonderful. You are worthy, oh Lord.
Woo! Wow, beautiful voice.
Thank you. Did
you come up with a vibrato?
Mm-hmm.
Not a thing or two.
Oh, Kumali.
But that was so, so beautiful.
Thank you very much.
And yes, she is a worshiper, an amazing, amazing worshiper. And as you can tell from the song that she sang, My Heart is Yearning, it's Kama ujisikia, make sure you run to YouTube. Danielle Kitho is her YouTube channel. Make sure that umefika hapo, subscribe. Wewe sikiza huo wimbo, you will be blessed.
Yes.
So Danielle, who or where did you grow up? Let's start with, did you know that you would sing like that growing up?
Well, first things first, we were born in Nairobi. So when my dad received the call to start a church, he came to Nyeri.
Okay.
So we came this side when I was about 2 years old.
Mm-hmm.
But they would always tell me that at three, I would go to the back of the house and I would put like stones or pick the pillows from the house and I'd have like an imaginary, you know, audience.
Okay.
And I would be singing. I would tell him, okay, now clap your hands. If you're happy and you know, you know, and sing different songs.
Yeah.
And I would be teaching or whatever, but I would always have an audience.
Yeah.
So it's like, you know, the spotlight just knew that.
Yeah.
So I started singing when I was really young. By the time I was four, you know, these productions that you have in church, like Christmas cantatas, Christmas concerts.
Yes, yes.
I'd always be there. Oh, my name is Danielle and I have a song. So I would always sing and yeah. So I think now as I continued growing up, that talent was grown mostly in my high school. Because I went to a high school where now I did voice lessons.
Yes.
So I had a teacher that would take me through that. Her name is Miss Grace Nangabo.
Beautiful.
Ah, that lady.
Tiga.
So Miss Grace really now trained my voice.
Yes, yes.
Because you know it's very important for your voice to be trained. You can have a good voice, but without training, you know, pitch and everything.
Yes, yes.
So I got training when I was in high school. And now that's when I also studied music. So I didn't know that I would be where I am today, but singing, I sang from a pretty young age.
Wow.
Yes.
So even in primary school, to see in the high school Kwanzaa, you would, you know, did you have this, what do they, festivals and all that?
Hey, let me tell you, I put my school on the map.
Oh.
Kenya Music Festival. That is where I would dominate. Kabisa. By the way, I lived for music festivals.
Wow.
Kabisa. I would go, I would be in the choir, I would do solos. Yes.
Wow. And I can tell right now it also translated to your books. Yes. Wow, that's so beautiful. So now you went to high school and it continued.
Oh, yes.
Would you say it was influenced by your parents being church leaders?
I believe so.
Mm-hmm.
I believe so because you see, it's always a thing. Yeah. I don't know whether you've interacted with pastors' kids.
Yes.
You know, you're the first in church.
Yes.
You're going to be the last ones, and you have to serve in departments and everything. So, but it's like it's something that is, you know, grown and you just Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I think it was really influenced by my folks.
When you talk of pastor's kids, mm-hmm. I tend to now go to the negative side of, mm-hmm. did you ever get to be rebellious at any point?
Yeah, by the way.
What? You should know they are watching.
Uh-huh. Well, mom and dad, you raised me well.
We thank God for them. Wow.
Uh-huh. Yes, I. Uh-huh. You see now, mm-hmm. by the time I'm getting to university,
yes,
I'm like, I've been in church mm-hmm. from when I was, you know,
little.
Young.
Yeah, yeah.
So when I got there, mm-hmm. I'm like, I want a different crowd. Mm-hmm. So I mixed myself with different people.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. For a certain duration of time.
Yes, yes.
But Mungu ni nani, if you have been called,
yeah.
no matter where you are, he will find you.
He will.
Yes.
He always does.
Yes.
Wow. Wow. Yes. And so now you interacted with these people. Mm-hmm. Did they ever tell you, you know, I think when you're a child of God, mm-hmm. there's always that aura mm-hmm. that you emit.
Yes.
Would they tell you, hey, Danielle, labda mnaenda out. Mm-hmm. See you tuombe.
Always. Mm-hmm. And they would always, you know, make fun of me, bishop's kid, pastor's kid,
yeah.
You know.
Oh yeah. My goodness.
Tuimbie kapambio.
I'm kakwa bash.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yes.
And so that whole talent was mm-hmm. being nurtured still
yeah.
at Elko.
It uh-huh. was.
So you would actually continue encouraging children right now. You know, kuna CBC and all that.
Yes.
You would encourage them, you know. Yes. What a talent yako.
Kabisa.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
How about your boys? How are you raising them? Like, which are you a talent?
Yes. Uh-huh. Actually, mm-hmm. My firstborn is 1 and a few months.
Uh-huh.
So I have purposely mm-hmm. been playing my song for him on repeat. So, of course, he's learning how to talk.
Yeah.
But you can hear him just say, Yanni. So, but I can tell that he loves singing.
Yes.
So I think.
Okay. Apple. Okay. Uko sawa kabisa. All right. So now take us through maybe what are some of the challenges that you have faced growing up as a lady, mm-hmm. a pastor's kid mm-hmm. who's a lady, mambo na, you know, boyfriends, all that, they, you know,
yes.
and still being in line mm-hmm. with the word of God mm-hmm. and the armor of God.
Mm-hmm.
Ulianzia wapi kujua sasa? Kujua vizuri story na Bible, kusoma, mm-hmm. fellowships and all that.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So, definitely, my parents being pastors, we were always around, you know, church and Bible studies and everything.
Mm-hmm.
But one thing, mm-hmm. by the way, about my parents, mm-hmm. they would never, like, force us mm-hmm. to come downstairs, it's 5 a.m., it's time for Bible study, mm-hmm. it's time for morning devotion in the house.
Mm-hmm.
No. But they would have a lot of keshas
mm-hmm.
At home, like Friday nights, would have, you know, prayer vigils mm-hmm. in the house and mm-hmm. everything.
Mm-hmm.
So I can say about knowing the word of God,
mm-hmm.
I had a pretty good, you know, foundation from my folks and just seeing them.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Yeah, just being around and going for crusades to Lienda.
What else you feel?
Yes. So that was there.
Mm-hmm.
But now, mm-hmm. you know, when you are a pastor's kid,
mm-hmm.
there are expectations
yes.
that are on you.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So people expect you to be like your parents.
Mm-hmm.
Especially now me who's in the ministry mm-hmm. and who's grown up serving.
Yeah.
Fun fact, mm-hmm. I have been a member mm-hmm. of the praise and worship team in my church
yeah.
since I was 10 years old. I've been singing on
wow.
that team
uh-huh,
from
uh-huh.
the age of 10.
Beautiful.
To now.
Uh-huh.
So, uh-huh. of course, you can see that I have been in ministry all my life, uh-huh. or most of my life.
Yeah.
So, there is that expectation where she should be exactly like her mom.
Yeah.
If she's given a chance to preach,
you
bring the house down like that woman of God.
Hey,
you know,
preach.
Or be prophetic like your dad.
Yeah.
So, those are the things,
mm-hmm.
yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Those are the challenges here and there. Or if, you know, and when you don't meet them or mm-hmm. when you're a bit, you know, different.
Mm-hmm.
Well, like, hey. Mm-hmm. And then there's always that attention or eye that is always on you.
Yeah.
So how you carry yourself mm-hmm. and everything.
Mm-hmm.
But my dad was a pretty, and still is,
yes.
a pretty, pretty strict
uh-huh.
man.
Well,
when we were growing up,
mm-hmm.
we had 4 German shepherds because okay. we are 4 girls.
Oh.
I am the last born.
Uh-huh.
So, 4 German Shepherds for each girl. Wacha nikwambie, dogs are supposed to be released at night.
Yes.
They were released daytime. Wewe unatoka kwa nyumba unaenda wapi? Kama sio kuenda kanisa unaenda wapi?
Yeah.
Or who is coming to see you daytime?
Who is that?
Yeah. Who is that? So hapo kwa boys, did not even imagine
coming home.
Did not even try to put it in their minds that they can even step close to that gate.
No. Mnasalimiana tu kumbali. Na shuleni.
Yes.
What?
Yeah.
That
was how we were. And then of course the age reached where the dogs went because then dad started saying, "Now girls, where are the people?"
Watu wako wapi?
Wako wapi?
Naleta mtu nini?
But yeah, growing up we interacted. Uh-huh. I interacted with boys, uh-huh. Yes, in church because uh-huh. there were so many church, you know, events and all.
Uh-huh.
But that fear,
yeah,
of my dad. Yeah, ilikuwa story nyingine.
You're like, I fear God.
Yes, I fear God.
Then there is my dad.
Yes. One day, tulikuwa tumetoka practice for a Christmas cantata. We do a lot of Christmas cantatas in our church.
Yes.
So, we had just come from practice. Mm-hmm. So this boy decided, wacha niku, I just take you to your gate because wanaishi tu uko nyuma. At the corner of my eye, I see my father's car. I tell the guy, it's either you run quickly in that different direction.
What if you run?
Run, my brother, run! He's like, I know your dad. Yeah. Say, come to church. See, he's my pastor. He's like, he comes, hi, Madhani. Tutapatana kwa nyumba. So basically, that's how the dynamic has been. So yeah. That's why when I got to university, I was like, now I want to interact with people freely.
Explore
everywhere and everything at the same time. So
so did you go like to, okay, was the school around your home area? Ama ulienda mbali ndukona, niugo.
Really, in a different county. I went to Meru. Yes. I went to Kenya Methodist University.
Yes. Oh, beautiful. And so, huko Meru, I understand kuna, you know, Mira. Did you ever try it?
Let me tell you, where you're told when in Rome, you do?
What Romans do.
Yes. So, one day, I just said, ebu nipe. Nikasema, I'm not, it wasn't.
I can attest to that because I once tried. Praise Jesus. Yeah. I tried it and I was like, okay.
Kidogo, it was giving goat vibes.
You know? You're chewing and you're like, wait, what are you doing? And then it's bitter and stuff
not
like that.
Me,
not
no, me.
Of course. And I can tell, you know, when you have that freedom, you want to explore all that.
Exactly.
And I would say these are some of the schemes that the enemy would use.
Yes.
Would you say you had the full armor? Ama, you got born again at the age of 3, ukakua uko sawa. Ama, at what time did you realize now I should be ready to fight against the enemy?
Yeah. So I got saved pretty early. But I believe at that time when I got saved, it was for the wrong reason. I had just finished KCPE. So when the car, my dad has just picked me up from school.
Yeah.
I tell him, Dad, I want to get saved. He's like, oh, yes, my daughter.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, you've made the decision for yourself. In my heart, I'm like, hey, God, give me a good mark.
You want to be on God's good side.
Yes. So I got saved then, and yeah, continued living life, and I'm like, I'm sorted. But really when I actually, you know, made that decision in my heart is after that period of time when I can say that I rebelled in, you know, university. You know, when you stray.
Yes.
And you go and, you know, you're living a life that is totally opposite from, you know, what you have been grounded in, what you've been raised in, there's a certain nakedness, there's a certain vulnerability, there's, you just feel like,
going to something.
There's something that is off.
Yes.
And that is when I made it, and I made that point that yes,
you were to stand
firm. I'm going to stand, and I'm going to remain.
Wow.
Yes.
Yeah, because then I read a certain statement that said, the enemy is the father of all lies and confusion. And when you're born again, he will be telling you, hey, Mudoni, aji sasa, ulikuwa pijana, ulikuwa na nani, you know, and he wants you to doubt your salvation. So would you say you were doubting your salvation, ama you had realized, enyewe, I'm not walking in light? And what would you tell someone who thinks, ay, nimeokoka kweli, bado ama kunaendaje?
What I can say, yes, you know, the devil makes it it's actually his main thing.
Yes.
His agenda is three things: steal, kill, and destroy.
Right.
So when he steals your purpose, that is like now taking you and derailing you completely, you know, far away from your destiny.
Yes.
And when you try to come back, he will always, you know, bring those things. Are you
bado?
How can you go back? Can you see what you I know where you were last night, and everything. But you see, the Spirit of God is always convicting. You know, he's always there. He's always there. And that's why, you know, Jesus gave him to us. You know, when he ascended, akasema, I have left you the Holy Spirit.
True.
So he's always there correcting, teaching, you know, reminding. So I can say that the Holy Spirit was one who was really convicting me and telling me, you need to come back. Get back. Yes.
So you would say that if you're not feeling anything, you're on your own. You're the Alice that was.
Yes. Hey, uko hapo. Karibu tupwe.
She actually once told me that if you are at peace with your sins, you are at war with God.
Exactly.
And that is so true, and it struck me seriously because I thought, wait, what? That's so dangerous. Like, how can you be at war with God? Dear viewer, kindly be very careful. I wouldn't want to be on that side of, because you can never win against God. Now, when we come back, because we want to take a very short break, when we come back, Danielle is going to be telling us about her purpose, how she realized what her purpose was, and how she got to even record her song that is so beautiful, My Heart is Yearning, and she will be touching on it when we come back. Keep those comments coming in. We'll see you after this.
My soul sings in the morning. Hello.
Jesus, the True Vine Church, Othaya, a city of God. Mrakurehera, prophetic revival meetings. Nikobriga tetuka tariki komie, jige mudenye wa kiumia, tariki kominenya, muruturi wakana. Kumbaga tetu ginyagia jumamodhi, nikobriga mugonye shia merho, jige thai komine moshia hawaini. Friday kesha, anerikobriga thai tetu shautko, jige thai komine moshia rushini. Sunday service, nikobriga thai tetu shia rushini. Host, ne Pastor John, nake muga ni wagateyo, ne one and only, prophetic love. Kuma furi wa Uganda. Itogore rito, ne maudu mamartu kumatene wa keri. Chapter 20, kobri hao minogoyri. Mwyo kei moda ni gaiwanyu, na ne gumbu turie mwyo hadete wega. Nige, itika gira ishigo shi na fi yake, na ne mwri giyaga no hotani. Inyode, mwri anyi teogani.
Exhilarating days, the hills and valleys of Nyeri County came alive with the vibrant energy of cultural expression. Welcome to Nyeri Cultural and Tourism Festival's auditions, a journey of talent and passion that spanned across all corners of the region. From the rhythmic beats of the traditional drumming to the graceful movements of indigenous dances, the audition celebrated a rich tapestry of Nyeri's cultural heritage. But the festivals didn't stop there. Contemporary dances groups dazzled the audiences with the innovative routines, blending the tradition with the modernity in mesmerizing displays of creativity.
Sanaa,
From the eloquent words of the young poets to the soul-stirring melodies of the local musicians, from the vivid strokes of the artist's brushes to the theatrical brilliance of the aspiring actors, the auditions showcased a depth and the breadth of the talent within Nyeri's communities. The auditions are not just a showcase of talent, but a celebration of unity, as both young and young at heart came together to share their gifts and passions. As the audition drew to a close, the stage is set for the main event, the Nyeri Tourism and Cultural Festivals. Join us on May 17th and 18th as we come together once again to celebrate the best of the Nyeri's culture, talent, and spirit.
Welcome back to Arise with me, Glashim Budhia, and in studio today we have Danielle Kitho, and we have been hearing from her, her story and how strict her dad was and still is. And it's such a blessing to know that indeed those parents brought her up the right way and in the way of the Lord. Now, dear parents, make sure that your children, wamejua tu njia za Mungu, wamejua how to protect their children from the, okay, or the children themselves to know how to fight against the enemy through the whole or the full armor of God. As I told you earlier, when we come back, she would be touching on My Heart Is Yearning Kidogo as we get to know how she learned her purpose, and we see what happens after that. So karibu tena.
Thank you.
So My Heart Is Yearning.
Yes.
Ilifikaje sasa ukaona, okay, now I can write my own song. I have been in the praise and worship team forever. Sasa ni wakati wangu.
Yes.
And it's during this era where people are doing live recordings, yes, and all that.
Yes.
And it's so beautifully done. Mm. And in Nyeri.
Thank you.
Hapa Nyeri. Why? Nyeri County.
Aki.
Watch out for Nyeri County.
Yes.
You know? So it's doing so well. Mm. So how did you come to that point?
Hey, mm-hmm. Now let me tell you, mm-hmm, I am the type of person, mm-hmm, I would always say that I have been blessed by God, mm-hmm, to sing other people's songs. I sing them so well.
Vizuri sana.
So well.
Yes,
so
yes.
For me, I just listen to these songs, mm-hmm, and I'll do them. But writing, mm-hmm, no, because, uh-huh, I tried a couple of times. You sit down and you're like, Holy Spirit, give me that song.
Yes, yes.
So, mm-hmm, it's so funny, mm-hmm, but that is why the Bible tells us we cannot understand the ways, mm-hmm, of the Lord.
True, true.
I got these songs in the span of 2 weeks.
You have, mm-hmm, been yearning this,
yes,
whole time.
Hey. Uh-huh. In the span of 2 weeks, it's like one song after the other, after the other, after, uh-huh, the other. Uh-huh. So at the time when I got this song, My Heart Is Yearning, mm-hmm, it was actually the first song, mm-hmm, that I got,
yes,
out of the 10 that I did,
yes,
in the live recording,
uh-huh,
so it was the first one, and it was, you know, I was just doing my devotion, mm-hmm, and I was reading, you know, as the deer pants for the water,
mm-hmm,
so my soul longs and thirsting and thirsting,
yeah,
and also Psalm 63, my soul, mm-hmm, longs for you,
mm-hmm,
Then, you know, the Holy Spirit just dropped those words in my heart.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, ni mimi nimeandika. Hey.
Wow.
Eh?
Wow.
And, uh-huh, my husband, eh,
babe, check it. Ola.
Tell me, is this making sense? It came as a total surprise to me.
Yeah.
Because I never believed that I would ever write a song.
What?
Yes.
So was it like in prayer, Ama umeketi tu, and then the Holy Spirit was like, hi. Zile songs ulikuwa unataka.
Exactly. You know, I always say that I'm a very dramatic person and I'm a very vivid person.
Yeah.
So that is exactly how it was. I was just sitting, minding my own business.
Yes.
Then you just hear very, you know, the sound of the voice of God is very clear.
Yes.
It's never at a muffled at a very clear.
Yes.
These are the lyrics. This is this. So wow. Some part a tune. Your musical, find the tune. You know.
What? What? Yes. And it's amazing how he gives you the gift.
Yes.
You know, Tango Kiwa Mtoto. Mm-hmm. So you are being prepared for all this.
Oh, yes.
And then they say that the partner you choose for life is very important.
Yes.
Very important. Mm-hmm. So tell us a little bit about your husband and how he has supported you throughout this journey.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So my husband, Noah Kido, he is number one, my manager.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Uh-huh. Wow.
And ananipanga. So he really, when I came to him and I told him, hey babe, it's like God is dropping songs in my heart. And he's like, hey.
But before that, before that, the point where you were meeting. Hey. Were they German shepherds? No, they had already.
When Jenny kwambia nililenga this man. You know, he inboxed me on Facebook.
Allah.
Hey.
Ati hi.
Like, who are you? And you know, me ni FBI. I did my investigation. I asked a friend of mine because I'm like, hey, our wanaka wako the same church. Kaniambia, this is our youth pastor. Pastor.
Okay.
Now, Mimi, I have been raised by pastors. Not.
Taki,
can
Anna.
Never be me.
Na plan ya God ni hiyo. Yes. Unakata.
Imagine.
Wa.
I blue ticked him on that. It was a blue tick on Messenger. I blue ticked him for many months. He was so relentless. Akatuma hai ingine. I'm like, "Kwani this is those Indian?"
How many? Yes, yes, yes.
Hey. Akatuma ingine. I just said, "Okay, fine. Hi."
So, Basi, hi to what is it? Like, you know, she had to hi.
Yes.
When they were stories in the Facebook.
Then, so he asked me to go for coffee.
Okay.
Yes. So, I was like, you know, I'm in a hurry. I have a flow practice.
Yeah.
So, please let this coffee date be just 30 minutes. 30 minutes.
Busy lady.
Look at 4 hours. What are you looking at after? Excuse me, madam.
Okay.
Where are you? Event is in 2 days. I'm like, I'm coming.
Did you ever go?
Yes, I had to.
Kupitia. Like, niko hapa. Technical appearance.
So that is how
okay. And so you knew that indeed this person was going to support you.
Kabisa. Yes.
Okay.
The way he supports me is very
overwhelming.
The number of times I can be asleep, deep sleep, then I just say, Mahat kumbe, America on all devices, TV.
What? He's extra. He wants to do it. Kabisa,
yes.
Kabisa.
Yes.
Wow. That's such great support.
Yes.
And now, unes advice to and a watch. Unes mambia nini kusu, you know. How do you know that person ni yeye?
I'll make a statement. When you know, you know.
When you know, you know.
Because it's never what you expect. Never.
Okay.
Because, you know, us ladies, we like having a list.
Yes, yes.
You know, this is in my checklist.
Yeah.
He's ticked all the boxes.
Yeah.
If we were going with mine, my husband ticked none of those, except light. Because sasa nikasema I'm dark, sezi kuwa na mtu dark.
Of course.
Wacha tukue, you know.
Yeah.
We balance it out. So, apo kwa light, ndio ali
na God-fearing.
And God-fearing, yes. But everything else was not. But I think when you are in the purpose of God, and when you have aligned yourself with, you know, what God has called you for, even your spouse, yes, mm-hmm. your husband or your wife, yeah. you will know mm-hmm. the moment you meet that person.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow. Okay, that's yes. so beautiful.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Your future husband.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Wherever you are. Mm.
All right, so now we get back to the point where now you started writing the songs.
Yes.
And he was there to support you.
Yes.
When did you decide, okay, now, Nico ready, let's hit the studios, let's go record the songs.
Mm-hmm. That was another, you know, process.
Yeah.
Because I was like, I have the songs.
Mm-hmm.
So I've sang them, you know, I've made him sit
yeah.
in the sitting room.
Mm-hmm.
I perform. Yeah, is it making sense? Mm-hmm. Is it? So now, mm-hmm. they going out to, you know, someone else
yeah.
and try skiza hizi songs, tell me if there's something.
Mm.
So the person who now I went to was my mom.
Mm-hmm.
I told her, Ebu, just listen to these songs. Because my mom is very, hey,
uh-huh.
my mother.
Uh-huh.
Let me just say she's something. She's a pillar.
Wow.
And
the
you know, she's very prayerful.
Mm-hmm.
And so when I was going to her with those songs,
yeah.
I wanted her to just gauge.
Mm-hmm.
Just gauge them.
Yeah.
Am I in this? Niko kwa roho ama nimetupa? Because
yeah.
you know, sometimes you can write but you see at the back mm-hmm. of a song,
yes.
what do you want? What mm-hmm. message mm-hmm. do you want
mm-hmm.
to pass?
Yeah.
What is this?
Mm-hmm.
So I really wanted her to gauge for me. And so I took them to my mom and she was like, yes,
wow.
good.
Amen.
There are
wow.
corrections she made, uh-huh. told me, add this, go to the Bible, fanya hivi, you know.
What?
And that. The
what?
Uh-huh. Now, to the point of live recording,
mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. I just wanted to do just a normal worship experience in church
mm-hmm.
and, you know, do other people's songs
yeah.
and then ingiza mine apo kati kati and say, guys, that's my song.
Wow.
Wow. Then I was told no.
Uh-uh. What?
I remember words of a dear friend of ours,
mm-hmm.
a brother,
mm-hmm.
an older brother of mine,
yeah.
Pastor Solomon Sila.
Mm-hmm.
He told us
mm-hmm.
In our church the last time that we had a worship afternoon,
yeah.
he said, there's mm-hmm. no one else who is going to come here
yeah.
to this church to sing
uh-huh.
their songs. Ni wewe sasa, you will do yours. I told him, you are funny.
And he is funny.
He's funny. Uh-huh. I told him, hey, me, songs.
Uh-huh.
Okay. At the time, you know, of course, I was like, hey, me, I'm not a writer. God has not anointed me to write.
Right.
Hmm.
What?
Imagine.
What? And here you are.
Yeah, yeah.
And here you are. Wow. I hope you're following that whole story. And I mean, the Lord has been so good as she takes a sip of water, you know. Ili aweze kurekebisha ko. We would like for her to touch on that song, Kidogo. And of course, tumesema leo jioni, tunaenda pale Peniel Interdenominational Conference,
mm-hmm.
Karatina Stadium. Tujifikisha uko sisi wote, we go get our blessings
yes.
and praise the Lord and let the Lord be glorified in Mount Kenya region, Nyeri County, kila
amen,
mahali,
amen,
sawa sawa.
Amen.
So, Danielle.
Yes.
Touch on that song for a bit. I don't like that. Time is not on our side. I
yes.
don't like that. We should continue the whole day.
I know.
You know? So touch on that song, Kidogo,
mm-hmm.
and then tutaendelea in a few. Yeah.
You want to sing with me?
Wow. Wow. What answer?
My heart is yearning, yearning for more of you. My heart is yearning, yearning for more of you. Come fill my heart, God, I'm desperate for more of you. Come fill my heart, God, I'm desperate for more of you.
Okay, we could now do it together. Nimekunywa maji. All right. Tuanze.
My heart is yearning, yearning for more of you. My heart is yearning, yearning for more of you.
come fill my heart, God. I'm desperate for more of you. Come fill my heart, God. I'm desperate for more of you.
Such a beautiful song.
Good.
Make sure you go to YouTube and follow Danielle Kitho. She is an amazing gospel minister of the word of God through music, through worship songs. And it has been such an honor. Such an honor having you in studio today. But of course, you wouldn't leave without leaving, our viewers with a word of encouragement.
Yes.
Kuna yule ambaye anaona, kwetu ni mashinani na uko ndani, you know. Where are people ever going to hear me from? Chachetu ikona watu 18. Mm-hmm. How do I even grow out of all this and go out into the world like Danielle has done?
Well, God's timing.
Mm-hmm.
And it's God's timing. Let me say that it's God's timing. And when it is your season,
mm-hmm.
Like in our church, it is our season of open doors,
mm-hmm.
and I claimed that thing when our bishop was declaring it.
Mm-hmm.
I said 2024
mm-hmm.
is my season.
Yeah.
And sometimes you can think you are so insignificant mm-hmm. because of where you come from,
mm-hmm.
and maybe people don't invite you to go sing mm-hmm. or minister in other churches.
Yeah.
But you see,
mm-hmm.
God sees.
Mm-hmm.
God sees everything.
Yes.
And if He has called you to, I like saying that worship is for the body of Christ.
Yes.
So if you have been called
mm-hmm.
to that,
mm-hmm.
then you have been called to nations. You have been called to, touch the body of Christ, to minister,
mm-hmm.
to minister healing, to minister what they need.
Mm-hmm.
And so when it is your time for God to remove you from the shelf,
mm-hmm.
it
mm-hmm.
you will be ready.
Mm-hmm.
You will have been tried and tested.
Yeah.
That is a topic for another day, because I'm not here because of anything else, but because I have been tried and I have been tested and I have been proven.
Wow. So Aishi kwa tested.
Yes.
You must be proven.
Yes.
Beautiful.
Yes.
So
your time will come.
Uh-huh.
And when it comes,
uh-huh.
it is like it's a veil that uh-huh. will be uncovered.
Wow.
Yeah?
Wow. Uh-huh.
Your name will be everywhere. People, you're like,
mm-hmm.
How has it happened? But it is because you are in the perfect will of God.
Wow. Yes. Perfect will of God.
Yes.
Hey, that is so beautiful. Like, there could be, they say there is the permissive will mm-hmm. and the perfect will.
Yes.
When you guys were acting here,
mm-hmm.
You said Alice,
mm-hmm.
kuna, God allows her to try fight for herself
mm-hmm.
and all that.
Mm-hmm.
So he permits that.
Yes.
And then when you are in his perfect will, he takes over completely.
Exactly.
Why not have Danielle here again and again and again? She's such a blessing. So for people who would say and think, tutaendaje Living Faith Ministries, tutafikaje huko, and you even have other, such amazing worship sessions.
Mm-hmm.
What do you have in store for us?
Mm-hmm. Actually,
uh-huh.
this coming week
uh-huh.
on Thursday,
okay.
that is the 18th.
18th.
We have an evening of worship.
Wow.
The LFM.
Ukonyeri.
Yes.
Yes.
Uh-huh. So we have amazing worshippers
uh-huh.
that are going to be with us.
Yes.
We have our very own Pastor Solomon Sila.
Uh-huh.
He's a son in the house.
Yes. Yes.
And we are very graced
mm-hmm.
to have Minister Fortune Ebol.
Why?
Mm-hmm. All the way from Nigeria. Eh?
Mm-hmm.
Eh?
Mm-hmm.
We have another minister,
uh-huh.
Derek Martin.
Mm?
I said I'm going to wing their name so that
it's international.
It's international.
Yes, yes. Uh-huh.
All the way from Tanzania.
Uh-huh.
So we are going to be there
uh-huh.
in Living Faith Ministries on
wow.
Thursday, 18th from 5:30 p.m. Wow. It's going to be amazing.
Is it like a whole night worship?
No. Uh-huh. Not we can, because you know it's a Thursday.
Yes.
And the following day some people will be going to work.
Yeah.
So it's going to run, but not the full night. Mm-hmm. So mm-hmm. yeah, from 5:30 p.m.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
Wow. Do you know what the beautiful thing is?
Mm-hmm.
Arise, we'll be covering that.
Oh, yes. Wow.
By the grace of God.
Yes.
We'll get to hear their stories. Mm-hmm. We're planning on that. So pray for us. Mm-hmm. Pray with us mm-hmm. that the will of God prevails.
Yes.
Perfect will of God.
Yep. Perfect will of God.
Yes, and even if we don't mean takuko, so make sure you join us too, yeah? See how Nyeri is blessed, yeah? After Peniel, we are now going to...
Oh, yes, you know, Nyeri, yeah.
Such a blessing, mm-hmm. and I could not thank God enough for giving us such an opportunity, you know, to have this amazing worshiper in studio with us, and I can attest, tested mm-hmm. and proven.
Proven, yes.
Yes. Nimefanya hizo tatu, mm-hmm. and she has the word of God. She has the armor of God Amen. On her. The quote of the day today, siku wasomea quote, and the way it was interesting, mm-hmm. it was saying, give me just a second, musiondoke, it is right here. It says, all right. Quote of the day, armor is heavy. Yet it is a proud burden, and a man standeth straight in it. Mm-hmm. Armor is heavy,
yes.
yet it is a proud burden. It is a burden that is proud because it knows you need it.
Yes.
You need it. Mm-hmm. So where's your panya bila you? Mm-hmm. And you need it as much as it is heavy, carry yes. it.
Yeah.
Usichoke.
Yes.
And do not pick up point to say, he helmet mm-hmm. your salvation.
What an enjoy.
Chaka kicho kwanza kabri apana.
Yes.
Go having that helmet all the way,
yes.
so that even after all these trials,
yes.
after the tests, after the Can't. Waves that the enemy sends to you,
yes.
you will stand.
Yes.
So until we meet next Sunday,
yes.
do you have anything else to add? Maybe you could tell them how they can reach you on your social media sites.
Yes, yeah. please. You can find me on YouTube, Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
All my handles are at Danielle Kitho.
Danielle,
how you can find me. Yes.
All right.
Yes.
Perfect. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
We are so blessed here. So God bless you. God mm-hmm. bless you. Keep it right here after this. Of course, as usual, we have our brother Chris and DJ TRZ on Wururumo. Usitoke hapo. Keti tu. Endelea. Lakini, kama unaenda church, toka mbiu. Toka mbiu. You can always watch it on GTN TV Digital. Utapata hapo. Sawa, sawa. Mm-hmm. So God bless you. Keep you well. And tupatane pale Peniel Interdenominational Conference after this, Ama in the afternoon. Sawa, sawa, God bless you. See you. My soul sings in the morning. I love the King, and He loves me, and all that I'm compelled to be is my.